What happens when you put 22 of Australia's larger-than-life stars of reality television, sport and entertainment in one show? You get the Challenge Australia.
Welcome to the Challenge Australia.
I have a phobia of heights, so it'll be interesting to see what happens.
So now I can just never
spar
again.
What the f*** have I got myself in for?
I have a lot of history with people in here.
I'm going to play to her, and it ain't going to be pretty.
Always fair, love and war, baby.
I'm competing with athletes, Olympic champions. Like, I'm a makeup artist.
That looks unreal. Two of the show's challengers, a singer Jack Vigen, a reality star, Cyril Paul. They join us now. Welcome to Studio 10. First question, are you guys mental?
Yes, a little bit.
What are you thinking? Those challenges look insane. What was it like?
Do you want to go?
You go.
Okay. Well, it was intense. I think we, like, or obviously we knew what we were going into in terms of the challenges, but for me personally, I haven't done, like, a show where there's a lot of drama.
Right.
And for me personally, that was the more intense part. The challenges were crazy.
I can't but imagine I feel you like have any drama in your life.
Well, only with my gay friends group. but no, yeah, it was very intense. That was the challenge for me, but what about you?
I think the biggest challenge was keeping my mouth shut because it seems to get me in a lot of trouble.
Well, Cyril, you are famous for your fiery personality. That would be fair to say on other reality shows.
Yep.
In fact, it's where you got your nickname Cyclone, Cyril. Let's have a look.
Oh, God.
You said you wanted to throw down at the reunion?
Oh, very mature.
What the hell is going on?
I'll show you a throwdown.
Very mature, darling. Very mature.
Oh, shut up.
So are you now just the quiet, shy, retiring type, or...?
Oh, no. Yes, I like to at home. That's full-on, isn't it, when you watch it back?
Mm, oh, bring fabulous. Back some memories.
Yeah, some good times. Actually, look, I'm going to get hated, but I enjoy doing that to her. What are you doing?
Okay. Still sending each other Christmas cards?
Oh, yeah, all the time. I usually write to her more on Halloween just to say how's your birthday going.
guys, the challenge was filmed in Argentina. What was it like doing all those crazy things in a foreign country?
It was fabulous. I think especially after COVID, it was my first time going anywhere overseas, so I was just in it for the ride.
Yeah. I think I was buckling. I kept a strong face, but I was scared.
Yeah. And also, you've got a little boy at home as well.
Yeah,
so you were missing him.
I think, yeah, my daredevil is gone now.
Yeah. Absolutely. Jack, you mentioned drama. How juicy did it get? Come on, spill.
Very, very juicy. I think in, like, the little clips that I've been posting, I mean, you see there's, like, some hookups and, I mean, obviously all that stuff's very normal, but, like, just when you're in a house and you can't leave in the middle of Buenos Aires, it's just a funny situation to be finding yourself in.
Yeah, there was
and
a spa.
And I also didn't know which side of Cyclone Cyril I would end up on.
He got the good one.
I did. I got the good side. We bonded very quickly, which was great.
I think that was good. Good advice.
I know, right?
Now, you've been on a few of these reality shows. You've been through the ringer on quite a few of them, but how does the challenge compare to other shows like I'm a Celebrity, for example?
The challenges were actually a lot different than I'd anticipated, I think, on the challenge. On I'm a Celeb, though, I was expecting the eating challenges. I was expecting all the ones that we kind of did, so I could kind of mentally prepare myself, but I don't think I really knew what to prepare myself for this one. But, yeah, they were interesting.
What was the scariest thing you had to do?
Well, I think you were mentioning before that one on the when you're on the side of the bus.
Oh,
the
I
truck.
Saw the ad for that on the weekend.
God.
And I nearly had a conniption. Like, how the heck do you do that? You've got to actually move across the side of a bus as it's moving.
Yeah.
And try not to fall.
Yeah. Yeah, no, yeah.
How do you prepare for that?
And you don't.
No. Well,
maybe it was
they
your
don't
time.
Tell you.
Maybe it was your time as a kebab on The Masked Singer that really helped.
Maybe that was it. You know what? Yeah. I was thinking the same thing. That outfit, costume, was the heaviest thing I've ever held on my back, ever. So I think maybe that was my, like, weight training for doing the challenge.
And what about you, Cyril? You know, there are fires, there are fast cars, there are explosions, challenges. Yeah. What was the most difficult thing, the most challenging thing for you?
I don't know if I'm allowed to say. You might have to stay tuned, but I will say there was one where I was pretty much praying for my life and
they forced you not to talk?
Yeah.
Whoa. Was that it? Oh,
no. No, no, all you got to do is get me drunk enough and I'll clonk out anyway.
Handy advice. Well, the Challenge Australia premieres tonight at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. Jack and Cyrell, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you, guys.
I can't wait to watch.
Yeah, I'll be tuning in for sure.